Lighthouse of Alexandria. Pharos Island. From Wonder Diaries. The Lighthouse of Alexandria is one of the seven wonders of the ancient world, the most recent. It was a tall lighthouse made of stone, with characteristic architecture and whose remains are currently in the port of Alexandria underwater. The presence of the Alexandrian Pharos among the seven wonders of the world is thus a way of marking the power of the Egyptian kingdom during antiquity. Alexandria being the commercial, social, and intellectual center of this kingdom at that time. Constructed during the 3rd century BC, it was demolished definitively during the 15th century, when the region underwent major earthquakes. The Lighthouse of Alexandria was located on a small island called Pharos near the city of Alexandria. Designed by the Greek architect Sostratos and completed around 270 BC during the reign of Ptolemy II, the lighthouse helped to guide Nile River ships in and out of the city's busy harbor. Archaeologists have found ancient coins on which the lighthouse was depicted, and from them deduced that the structure had three tiers, a square level at the bottom, an octagonal level in the middle and a cylindrical top. Above that stood a 16-foot statue, most likely of Ptolemy II or Alexander the Great, for whom the city was named. Although estimates of the lighthouse's height have ranged from 200 to 600 feet, most modern scholars believe it was about 380 feet tall. Nowadays, Alexandria is Egypt's second largest city by population, and it is a coastal city of great importance, the country's gateway to the sea. But already in the 3rd century BC, the city was a center of knowledge as the world of the time was limited to the Mediterranean and the surrounding kingdoms. The most popular areas were literature, science, mathematics, astronomy, and medicine. Many scholars made discoveries that we always remember or that are still used. The city was covered with edifices whose purpose was to mark the power of the kingdom. By the end of the 3rd century BC, the population had increased considerably and so as trade. Due to strong naval activities, the famous lighthouse was built on Pharos Island at Alexandria. There were two reasons for the construction of the Alexandria Lighthouse. First of all, the utilitarian reason. The city had, at a short distance, an island called Pharos. Gradually brought closer to the land by the deposit of silt brought by the Nile, it became a peninsula, forming two curves tightening towards the earth, delimiting two natural harbors that were quickly used. Still, the Egyptian coast was dangerous. Flanked by reefs flush with the surface and even underwater, it had sent a large number of Greek and Roman ships to the bottom, causing human and material losses. To secure the port, it was necessary to build a lighthouse, which was done. The other reason was symbolic. A lighthouse was a rare building in the world, since it was difficult to build and maintain. It was therefore not only useful to build a lighthouse at the entrance to the port but also marked the power of Egypt, and more particularly of Alexandria. The Lighthouse of Alexandria was built of limestone from a quarry near the coast. It could have been the case, such as using marble, but in practice it was indeed limestone that was used. These stones had a clear appearance, which made the visitors say that the lighthouse was white. walls of the building, frames of the doors and windows, which were built of granite. The fitting of the stones was quite surprising. The manufacturers obviously did not use mortar to tie the stones together but used an old grooving technique. The stones were visibly assembled on a bed of molten lead, acting as a shock absorber. It took roughly 15 years to complete the lighthouse. The Lighthouse of Alexandria was a monolithic building that measured approximate 135 meter high. It was on three floors, on the ground, a heavy square building, on which was built another octagonal building. At the top, the third floor was cylindrical. This form with three levels is found in other lighthouses of the Greek Empire. The access door was fairly high in relation to the ground, so the lighthouse had an access ramp on the first floor, a ramp which was mounted on 16 impressive arches. The first floor was built on a platform about 10 meters high. It was pyramidal and square. The building itself was hollow and contained an access ramp on the second floor and about 50 rooms, so it was a real urban complex. These various rooms were used for the service of the lighthouse. There were rooms for the staff who kept the fire at the top, others for storing wood and food. The ramp was wide and allowed the passage for oxen to carry the wood towards the top of the lighthouse. It was illuminated by a series of windows, small and long, arranged along the ramp. This part of the lighthouse was 71 meters high and at its summit was a terrace equipped with a high railing of 2.30 meters and carved tritons blowing in horns, a means of preventing accidents at sea. The second floor was 34 meter high, about half of the first. It was octagonal in shape and like the first floor it was hollow, but unlike it, it was equipped with an internal staircase, not a ramp. It must be said that at this level the lighthouse was too narrow to make a ramp, so it was at the top of the first floor that the beasts of burden climbed the wood to burn at the top. For the rest of the trip, it had to be done by hand. The third floor was the lowest, only 9 meters. It had a cylindrical shape and was equipped with an internal staircase. At the top of the lighthouse there was a statue of Zeus or Poseidon or Ptolemy II or Alexander the Great. Little information has been received on the operation of the lighthouse, but there is not much to discover, obviously. The fire was lit on the highest part, the one on which there was the statue. It was important, visibly powerful, and it was maintained day and night. In the daytime, it was the smoke which directed the boats, at night it was the brilliance of fire. It appears that the lighthouse of Alexandria was visible to 50 kilometers in the round. In order to feed it, a large quantity of wood had to be stored in the first floor of the tower. A ramp, as indicated in the description, was the inner circle. Oxen were able to circulate there, stepping the trunks regularly for storage. In the course of time it was possible to switch to other fuels, especially oil. Some sources indicate that the lighthouse was equipped with reflective mirrors to increase its visibility. It seems to be false. The Lighthouse of Alexandria, built at one time, had obviously not undergone any major changes during its existence. In fact, the modifications were essentially natural ones. It was an earthquake that destroyed the third floor of the lighthouse during the 10th century. Lying on the ground, the summit was never rebuilt. In 1303, a second earthquake struck it again, more violently, and one-third part of the town damaged, so the lighthouse. But the destruction does not seem to have been complete, since Ibn Battuta was still able to describe the lighthouse in April 13, 49. It was only at the end of the 15th century that the lighthouse of Alexandria, or rather what remained of it, was completely dismantled. The stones were then used for the construction of Fort Cape Bay, which guards the entrance of the port of the city still today. Why did the lighthouse of Alexandria disappear? In fact, it's quite simple. It has undergone two events. First of all, it was abandoned and without maintenance. It was found in the 10th century heavily degraded after an earthquake dropped the third floor. It could no longer serve at that time, and it was a long time ago that he was no longer serving. The lighthouse could have been repaired and consolidated, but the Arab civilization of the early Muslim times did not have the magnitude of the previous civilization, so it was impossible for them to correct it. This period lasted until the end of the 15th century, when it was so degraded that it was demolished completely. Thanks for watching, friends, and see you in the next video.